Michael Jackson, as the biggest artist in pop history, has been called the king of pop and the artist of the century. After Michael Jackson garnered hundreds of millions of fans, he eventually shed his bubblegum image and his music became increasingly sinister. After Michael Jackson had much of the world firmly in his grasp, he began promoting gratuitous violence through video and music. Michael Jackson began to shock many of his fans as he began to demolish cars and storefront windows. Incredibly, Michael Jackson helped to open the door to the violence that would become the backbone of the rap music explosion that would follow in his wake. Michael Jackson also promoted gratuitous sex among his millions of young, impressionable fans by grabbing his crotch in videos and stage performances. So perverse were Michael Jackson's sexual antics that they even shocked some of those working with him on set.
And all of a sudden, Michael started fondling himself and did this movement and was like, "Cut! What the f*** was that?"
Eventually, Michael Jackson would be accused of the grossest form of sexual perversion in his private life. Michael Jackson was especially fond of hanging out with young children and afterwards spending the night with them in the same bed. While Michael Jackson's song, Billie Jean, was a sordid song about denying a relationship with a groupie, Jackson would later have to deny a relationship with a boy groupie. Michael Jackson was accused of child molestation by a 13-year-old boy whom he had spent several nights with in the same bed. Jackson was reported to have paid the boy millions of dollars to drop the case. To many, this was strong evidence that Jackson was guilty.
They served a search warrant on me, which allowed them to view and photograph my body, including my penis, my buttocks, my lower torso, thighs, and any other area that they wanted.
Michael Jackson not only exposed millions of his fans to sexual perversion, but also introduced them to occultic themes as well. Jackson depicted himself being transformed into a werewolf, long a theme within Satanism and the occult in his video Thriller. Michael Jackson featured himself along with many other ghouls terrifying a young woman. Michael Jackson tried to deny his own personal involvement in the occult, but later admissions contradicted his denial. Satanist Aleister Crowley had a special secret room filled with mirrors wherein he practiced his black magic and contacted demonic beings. Like Aleister Crowley, Michael Jackson also uses a secret room of mirrors to contact spirits. Michael Jackson has admitted that it is in this room that he communes with the spirit of Lee Liberace. Jackson revealed that, quote, "I have my own secret room with a moving wall and mirrors. That's where I talk to Lee. His is the voice I hear in there. I feel his presence so very close to me." Jackson added that Liberace is, quote, "like my guardian angel. He's even given me permission to record his theme song, I'll Be Seeing You." Obviously, Michael Jackson is not in contact with the spirit of Liberace, for the word of God states that one goes to either heaven or hell upon death. But like Satanist Aleister Crowley, Michael Jackson has opened himself up to the demonic spirit world, which is using him, like so many other rock stars, as a tool to damn the souls of men and women. It is from this demonic spirit world that Michael Jackson gets his songs. Jackson admitted, quote, "I wake up from dreams and go, wow, put this down on paper. The whole thing is strange. You hear the words. Everything is right there in front of your face. And you say to yourself, I'm sorry, I just didn't write this. It's there already. I feel that somewhere, someplace, it's all been done. And I'm the courier bringing it into the world." It appears that it is these demonic beings that energize Jackson when he hits the stage. Jackson stated, quote, "When I hit the stage, it's all of a sudden a magic from somewhere that comes and the spirit just hits you. And you lose control of yourself." God's word, the Bible, tells us that we are to test the spirits to see whether or not they are from God. Isaiah 8:20 says, "If they speak not according to his word, it is because there is no light in them." Michael Jackson, speaking like a prophet, claims that he's been sent forth to the world with a message. The word of God warns that we're to test those who claim to be prophets. The song We Are the World included several different artists, with Michael Jackson leading them at the helm. The song was described as being summoned. Let's look at some of the words of that song in light of God's word. The song states that we are the world, we are the children. The Lord Jesus Christ contrasted the children of the world, whom he said were the children of the devil, with those of the children of light, or the children of God. The song states that there comes a time when we need to heed a certain call, when the world must come together as one. God's word warns that demonic spirits would bring the world together as one to fight against Christ in the end at Armageddon. The song goes on to say, "We're all part of God's great big family, and the truth you know, love is all we need." The truth of the matter is that Jesus Christ is the truth. He said, "I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life, and no man comes to the Father but through me." It is a New Age lie that we are all part of God's great big family. Jesus Christ said, you must be born again to enter the kingdom of God. It is a satanic deception for these spirit beings to echo the lie of the Beatles that love is all we need. How can they speak of love when they crucify love incarnate on the cross in the person of Jesus Christ and continue to reject him? The song goes on to state that there's a choice we're making. We're saving our own lives. Jesus Christ said, if you save your life and keep it to yourself, you'll lose it. But if you lose your life and give it to him, then it will be saved. The song states, as God has shown us by turning stones to bread, and so we all must lend a helping hand. But Satan tempted Jesus Christ and said, turn these stones to bread. But Jesus answered, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes out of the mouth of God. It is interesting that Michael Jackson teamed up with both Paul McCartney of the Beatles and with Mick Jagger of the Rolling Stones. We have already observed the connection between the Rolling Stones' Satanic Majesty's Request and the Beatles' Sgt. Pepper Lonely Hearts Club Band album. We have seen that Sgt. Pepper is a likely reference to Aleister Crowley. Michael Jackson, during his incredible success, donned his own elaborate Sgt. Pepper-like outfit to collect his record-breaking 8 Grammys. Sadly, even as Paul McCartney sang in the song Sgt. Pepper, that it's certainly a thrill and we'd like to take you home with us. We'd love to take you home. Jackson, the king of pop, used his Peter Pan image to get into the hearts of millions of young children. In his video Thriller, we see that there's more of a hint of the diabolical powers that are using Michael Jackson as a puppet to take people away.